There we go.
Beautiful.
Well, it hadn't been a good evening. The new board didn't work, and the old board didn't work, and they're arcing off a couple of the components, so... And I can't find a short. Nothing. What happened? I don't know, but it sure is expensive night. We won $1,000 worth of electronics. Tomorrow's another day.
I have both of them dead now. That's what I did because I thought, well, shoot, I got a bad board, right?
Uh-huh.
So I went and got the other board and plugged it in. Fuck, it did the same thing, you know?
But when it starts pulsing,
mm-hmm.
that's when you'll start seeing the arcs across here. There, right there.
Oh, okay.
So maybe it's just this gap between there?
Yeah.
But it is amazing how long it's taking it to power down this morning.
Is it because this is still plugged in?
Oh. Maybe that's it. I got the wrong one. I turned off this one over here.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Well.
Okay. So, again, that board came from this, right? You just cut one of these up and drilled some holes in
them? No. This board, this is custom made.
So, you got this made from China?
No. Actually, I think it actually came from the United States. But anyway.
No.
Yeah, I think so.
They don't make anything here
anymore.
They
paid a high dollar on it. Yeah. So, See, it's got, its pins are laid out.
Okay, well, certainly...
But why is it arcing on that side instead of this side, when they're closer over here?
I mean, I don't know that much about PCBs, but I would definitely assume that this one could have some more insulation in the traces than this one, depending on, like, the quality and who made the board and what material they used. Because you're seeing the...
Okay, so you think maybe it's just the board.
I think maybe it's just fine. It's just these are... All right, there's not enough resistance between those two points. And so it's sparking. So if you...
Now look at that big hunk of solder I have over here, and it's not arcing on this side.
Yeah, just because it's easier to arc through the wires for whatever reason. If you put some divider, some insulation between those two, then you'll probably get an arc on the other side. But...
All right, let's try.
Right away. Yeah, if we can insulate those two points somehow.
How is it having all these people coming through and shit?
It's cool.
Is it?
Yeah. There's a couple of them that are...
Tell me about your worst experience. Cool. The ones you wish would leave.
Did you read through the guest book?
I flipped through the pages, but I didn't read anything.
You didn't see the Doug is an asshole entry?
No, are you serious? Someone that stayed in your house and wrote in your guest book that you're an asshole? That's hilarious. Who was it?
Well, I mean, at least they don't have any problem expressing themselves, right?
That's true. Yeah,
which is
I noticed there was no
more
girls.
Than we said for a lot of people.
There was no girls' names. What's to do with that?
That's our society telling women that they have to look good in bikini, not... on a lab floor, which I'm okay with, actually.
Yeah, me too.
But I think they're shorting themselves more than anybody else.
That's crazy.
Because you know what? When you just work on stuff, the older you get, the better you get at it. If you're trying to look good in a bikini, it doesn't work like that. The older you get, the worse you get at it, you know?
That's true. Look at how far apart those traces are.
Oh.
Look at how they go way the fuck over there. That's your problem.
Fuck!
I'm going home.
So, insulate it, maybe.
Yeah. Right now, let's just pour a bunch of liquid tape on it. But make sure your liquid tape doesn't conduct.
We kind of
you know?
Avoid the whole idea behind liquid tape.
Well, is it liquid electric tape? Is this it here?
Yeah,
well, that was here, like, 2 years ago or something.
We were working on this 2 years ago? Last time you were here, we were working on this. We did the,
Now, we... Every time I come, we do house chores.
I don't trust your skills.
Yeah. This is a new.
The first time you've actually got to use your real skills.
The first time we came, I came.
Well, you didn't have any skills. You were in school. In fact, I asked.
I'm still in school. I haven't graduated yet.
Oh,
yeah?
Yeah.
Oh,
shit.
I know.
You hear anything?
No chirping yet. Oh, there we go.
There, you got it? Thing.
Yeah. Looks like it's not arcing.
Oh, yeah, I hear it ticking.
Yeah.
Oh
my god, I earned my keep.
Yeah, you may have lunch or something.
Alright.
Yeah, I see no arcing. God, that's great.
Perfect.
Ah!
You don't even have to reprint your boards, you just...
Oh, it's working!
Oh, really?
Yeah! Yeah, we have signal!
Except...
Oh, yeah. Oh, well, a little bit of signal there. Yeah! Fucking A!
Dude, that's That's awesome.
That is sweet.
Break the board when it was barking away.
I mean, it was smoking.
And you're like, oh wow, yeah, I unplugged it, and it's well, it's still going for a while.
I figured that, yeah. Well, I unplugged it. Okay, I unplugged the wrong one. I know. Let's not go back and visit that.
Yeah, because it's too high of a resistance through that small trace. You got thicker traces there.
Yeah. All right. So see, it's not just that the traces are further apart; it's also that they're larger. You look at these two traces; much more copper in there than these the little ones. So we need to redesign our little board here, and that won't be hard to do. They don't cost much to have that done. See, here's one of our little boards we had made, and we actually get them made as one board and then cut them in half because we're even being cheaper, but that's what we got to correct.
No, leave it. Wait. No.
Get it, Jess. Be the wolf. Stay in the van. Don't give in to slavery. Be a dog. Be a real dog. Get up there. Get you. You're not here, little bitch.
Doesn't listen to the man.
He's your bitch. That's right. Get that food. You just take it.
Glasses. The big lenses. Oh, fuck. No, just screwed the whole thing.
Oh, the mounting screw.
The mount screw hole right there.
Okay, well, we sort of dodged a bullet. This was drilled out to be used as a mounting screw and it never got used. But now that I widened this hole out, they intersect. And that lets... Oh, wait a minute. Yeah, that's wet. And so that would allow water into around these threads, and it's too close to the inside. So, yeah, we'll put this in and then plug that with something. We're going to make a change to how we've been doing this. Instead of powering off this board by just yanking the power from it, we're going to use this signal cable, which Lawrence, I think, really wants you to use. So the power stays on all the time. When you drop power on the signal cable, the yellow one, that tells the board you're going to shut down. It actually takes 8 seconds then for the board to actually power itself down. I think it's probably doing some cleanup work, you know, saving defaults and such. So that's a better way to go. And when you power it back up with the yellow signal, it only takes 30 seconds before, or less than 30 seconds before, it's trafficking information back to the console.
Okay. So we're going to turn this on, and this is going to come on.
Yeah, that's about as deep as we can go. Should have started off with drill press. Much easier. Yeah, see, by doing it with the drill press, we can cut this little relief here on the side that gives the wires a little more clearance.
Yeah, that's the chai thing.
That's good to do lunch. Fourth time's a charm. Forgot, I got to make sure this capacitor lines up and fits that hole, so I had to rotate the board 180 degrees. Now, if you got one of these really nice Noga dial indicator holders, you've got the perfect makings for a great third hand. Just put a piece of dowel rod in there or something that fits. Put an alligator clip on the end, and that's going to work great. Put your part in there and loosen the knob, move it anywhere you like, tighten it back up, it stays there.
The diameter booms. Stuck the camera way out front to get into the props out of the view.
This is cool. I want to see it in the air.
Okay, we can do that.
Guy, you know.
Thank you. YouTube, you know Bart. This is Roger. This is Roger's boat, and Roger's boat, we're cleaning it up, doing a little work on it, because this is the boat we're going to start testing the ROV on, and hopefully we'll find a decent engine for that one back there someday. Well, I had hoped to have the ROV in the water next weekend, but that's not going to happen. But I'm really happy with the progress anyway. There's just more here to do than I realized, and well, isn't that the case with everything? We still got the fairings to figure out how to mount, and the wiring has to go through this intersection here. So we've got all that to work on. We're already working on improvements to the boards for the sonar hub. But still, we've got it where we can at least get it out and get it tested with what we have. There is something I am very happy about. This, you know, that some of the best things in life happen when you just don't push it. You know, people have said, "Why don't you go out and ask for sponsors and such?" And I just don't do that. It just takes a lot of time, and I don't know. Maybe I'm a little bit lazy, but this this is all free. From Rob over at DeWalt, and we are actually going to be testing some of their new equipment. So we definitely have to get back on the boat now, but it is amazing what showed up. Beautiful, I mean, DeWalt's already my favorite grinder, so you know, it's like, that's the other thing, is I have to lie about things when you're sponsoring and reviewing tools, and I don't have to lie about DeWalt tools. That's what I got over there on the wall already. That is my brand. You know, if it's Harbor Freight makes them too, you know, I know, and I like Harbor Freight, but I don't use Harbor Freight when I'm going to use it a lot, because you're just going to tear that stuff up. And so here's the job here is they gave me these things, and they said, you know, give it through, run it through its paces, and so that's like a command to try and tear it up. So it's like, heck yeah, I'll try and tear it up. And cordless too, 60 volts. That is going to be fun to try out. And I am not a believer in cordless tools. I mean, I just hate them because it's like the battery's always dead. So you can expect a nice, fair evaluation of it. And you know what? See, we were told to test them. So we're already shock testing the battery charger. I bet it's just fine. But anyway, many thanks to you, Rob. I appreciate you putting us on your list. Look at that. Look at that. There's like four of these, and this is exactly what we need to work the inside of the boat before we start painting. Not soon, but on the list, definitely. And, and even flat disc here. I mean, this is wonderful. So, what better way to end the video with a huge thank you to DeWalt. Love you guys. Thank you.